It's also inspiring.
A professional paleontologist is it's my resistance to them. It's my gas transmission as a human under attack.
Assets. and give up InfoWars, you would think he'd say, okay, I'm going to stick to my gun. I'm going to sit in court, and I'm going to ask for evidence. I'm going to ask for documentation. I want to see all these things other than a few pictures that they can easily Photoshop and show us on the news, because I'm not going to take the news verbatim for what they tell us, because there's always agendas behind the news. But what did he do? He went to court. He apologized. He said he made it all up for ratings and views. And he set the precedent for people like us. Once the digital ID is in place and you're tracked and monitored what you say on the internet, when you start questioning the news, when you start questioning these types of events like the Hook at Sandy, you will be prosecuted. You will be brought to court. You will risk losing everything that you have. You will risk potentially in the future going to prison over questioning the news. That's how a communist dictatorship works. Now, for those of you that don't know, the events that happen at schools, this is very hard for the sheeple to understand, okay? The government has wanted to remove the guns of civilians for a long period of time, right? Why wouldn't the government want to remove civilians' guns? So the government needs to come up with ways to be able to convince people to give up their guns. In 1991, in Bill Cooper's book, Behold the Pale Horse, he revealed in the book the plans, saying, quote, the government encouraged the manufacture and importation of military firearms for the criminals to use. This is intended to foster a feeling of insecurity, which would lead the American people to voluntarily disarm themselves by passing laws against firearms, using drugs and hypnosis on mental patients. In a process called Orion, the CIA inculcated the desire in these people to open fire on schoolyards and thus inflame the anti-gun lobby. This plan is well underway and so far is working perfectly. The middle class is begging the government to do away with the Second Amendment. This is in 1991. We are in 2024, okay? We are 30 years plus past this, actually 33 years, that's number 33, past this moment. And think about what's occurred since then. We get one almost every week now. We got it started, really the big one being in Columbine. And then, of course, this is filtered down, and there's always ones now. So think about how far we've gone with that plan. And, of course, the plan makes sense, but the civilians, when you know the people who are anti-people like us, they hear stuff like this. They can't wrap their heads around it. It's almost like they love these tragedy stories so much that they don't even want to believe that the government will make them up in the first place. It's incredible that they couldn't think that the government would formulate a plan like this. So you see a government who's going completely tyrannical. They've completely gone rogue. And they're stripping everyone of their rights. Well, what's the one thing they need to make sure they have before they go full on? Well, it would be to make sure they have everybody's weapons. Now, I believe that this is headed in, and Alex Jones is going to play a huge part in separating blue and red states. I believe that is the goal, the first step of the master plan here for the global government. Is to separate countries into two based on political ideologies. You have dual communism. I said it many times. It's hard for people to understand. I get it. But that's what we're headed towards. And people like Jones will play a very crucial role in that. Anybody who's into conspiracy, anybody who questions the government, you're supposed to align yourself with the Republican Party. That party has aligned themselves with us. They've hijacked a movement that could have been an organic movement of people waking up and stopping the government from doing what they're doing. Instead, people who are questioning the government are now forced into siding without realizing it with conservatives, with Republicans. The Republicans are working with the Democrats together. This is strategically being done. People like Jones, people like Tucker Carlson, they all tickle your ears. I get it. And people out there don't think this far ahead. So when a newbie hears my chat, they're like, well, what's the difference between you and them? Well, here's the difference. One, I'm a nobody, okay? Which means nobody knows who I am. And even people who used to know who I was and used to know my child don't know where to even find me. They've essentially murdered me off of the internet by forcing me to, you know, by removing all my work off of all platforms and then forcing me to make up a new name, right? In order to dodge anything, to make up new names, to be able to put... Essentially the equivalent of murder. That's what it is. Now, back when people like Bill Cooper were getting truth out. They had radio shows and things like that. Okay, they couldn't turn off the radio show. They had to turn off Bill Cooper. For someone like me, who, again, I'm not a big threat to them because they've done what they need to do. They've minimized my views. They've minimized my audience. I had a large reach for a long period of time. I mean, every video that I would put up would get a minimum of 50,000 views, right? So by killing off the reach, by... Not being able to reach new people, the message is dead, and that's all that matters to them. Back then, they had to kill people like Bill Cooper. And again, Bill Cooper, just like when I talk about the Mozart, right? I call it Mozart, excuse me. They whacked Mozart when he turned on the secret society, when he started exposing what they were doing. Bill Cooper started turning on the government, exposing secretive operations, okay? They whacked him because he turned on them. That's why I don't believe that he was a COINTELPRO agent. He'd still be alive, hurting people. Jones came in and stepped in for him. And even recently, Jones has been talking a lot about Bill Cooper, even though they hated one another. Okay, Cooper was openly on his radio show telling everybody that Jones was a government operative. So the other stuff to look at with Jones, in addition to him laying down in court, right? Because again, it was a perfect opportunity. If you really felt that way, right? And of course, we're supposed to believe that he felt that way. Like if I got brought to court, I would say, look, this is how I feel. What are you going to label me, a mentally unhealthy for questioning the news? They would never bring someone like me to court because I would call it out and I'd break it down and common people would hear me. And then again, this guy makes a point because nobody can deny that I'm not making a point clearly, crystal clearly. And they'd say, okay, fine. He really doesn't believe it. He really questions it. It's either you're going to label me with mental health. Does it sound like I have a mental health problem? Well, they'll probably say I do. I'm sure there's people out there who have real mental health problems who think that I do because they're living in a warped reality. But I'd say I want all the evidence presented to me. Convince me that's right. You can't just bring in parents who can very well be actors into a courtroom. You can't just show me photographs, okay? I want to look at it as if you're showing me a true crime episode. And I want to see everything. I want to see DNA. I want to see entire breakdowns of the existence of all these people, right? I want somebody to talk to me about the father who played two roles, which is the most obvious thing that occurred there, which is laughable that Jones didn't bring it up in court. The father who literally, he was there as a father of a victim, and then was also seen dressed up as an FBI agent the same exact day. And it was undeniable. I mean, you get past the duping the light. You can't get past that, right? Some people can look at the duping the light and say, well, emotionally he was all over the place, so he smiled. Okay, how about an actor who's playing two roles on the same day? Jones could have brought that up in court and said, who is this guy? Why do all these guys have IMDb page? He did nothing. He went to court. And he said, I was trying to get views, I was trying to get ratings, I made it up, which then makes everybody out there look at people like us as if that's why we do what we do, right? That's how it filters down. So everyone goes, oh, these people are, so this guy's just trying to get clicks on his videos. He's trying to get clicks and stuff. He doesn't really believe that the news is fake. No, I really believe that it's fake. In fact, I know for a fact that it's fake. And everybody who follows the channel knows that. But I would have sat in court and I would have wanted everything presented to me, right in front of me. And I would have said, look, this is my viewpoint. Why can't I question what I see? Why can't I think for 1 second that the government has gone rogue and is creating these events? And there's a lot of documentation out there about these operations, right? Like the process of Orion that I said earlier, that the government has documented that could very well be getting staged out. And say, oh, you're crazy? Oh, okay, well, prove to me that I'm crazy. I'll show you patents. I'll show you documents. But I want to see this thing broken down. And even after that, maybe I'll disagree, because in a courtroom, right, when OJ's on trial, many people thought everybody thought OJ was guilty, but somebody there thought he was innocent, right? And OJ got and again, whatever your take is on if that was real or not, but let's look at it from the perspective of a sheeple. Somebody thought he was innocent. Oh, okay. So why can't somebody have an opinion that's different than what the government tells us? Because it's beyond comprehension for people, because it's so mean and hurtful to think that they can be actors? Or is it because the people out there are so dumb and sheeple that they can't realize that the government stages these events so you emotionally want the things that the government want, which in this case is gun grab,
which in other cases is the removal of free speech. Why do you think they want free speech gone so bad? Why do you think they want people like me gone so bad? Because they're afraid that we're threats to take over their control, to overthrow them from this tyranny that they cause, which is a hypnosis. So what do they have to do? Well, they placate to the LGBT, to weak. They make people weaker and weaker, more emotional, and they call it hate speech. And people go, no, we're talking about hate speech. You can't say this word or that word. It hurts someone's feelings. And then they don't see how it spreads down and it removes free speech. These are all things that the government has created to protect themselves. Because people out there don't realize who they really are, and if they realize what they really did in darkness, the rituals that are performed, the things and acts with children, they wouldn't just be overthrown. They'd be removed from the earth for the things that they're doing. And especially people out there realize why they're depressed, why they have anxiety, why they're confused, all these things that they're doing with 5G and radiation, all the poison in our food. You realize that these are a bunch of mass murderers. These are a bunch of psychopaths, 10 times worse than any serial killer you've ever been told about. Okay? So they need to remove all these things to protect themselves. That's why they care so much about these things. They're trying to protect their own arses, so to speak. So Jones could have done all this stuff in court. And there's so many things with Jones. The Bohemian Grove thing is a huge thing. Okay? Anyone out there that thinks that you can get into Bohemian Grove and film it and live to talk about it, and not only live to talk about it, build an empire like InfoWars, give me a break. Okay? That should be enough for people to go, yeah, Jones, you couldn't get a camera in to film it. You couldn't. You say, why would they do that? Why? Because they start giving you tastes of truth because they know that people might start waking up to stuff. They want you to go to Jones for the truth. Because Jones, at the end of the day, might be giving you truth, but he's not. Not only is he not giving you answers, he's leading you in the wrong direction. How often does Jones promote the actual people responsible for everything going on? Never. Right? You never hear about those bagel biters from Jones. Here and there, he might throw something out, but you never hear about it in the long run. You never hear him talking because that's who he works for. So sometimes he'll throw a little truth out there to make sure his audience is, you know, thinks that he's not COINTELPRO, because so many people over the years have exposed him as COINTELPRO, going back to Bill Cooper. Okay? I get it why people like Jones. He's great on the mic. Okay? I mean, he's a good character. You know, I mean, he's an interesting character. He's an intriguing character. He's, you know, you listen to him, and you don't want to. He's not boring. He's not monotone. He's got a personality. So, of course, I understand why. Just like Trump, you know, they have a showmanship to them. But that's by design, okay? So the government would take care of all these people. These people still have platforms. And Jones isn't really going to lose any of the money that he has. This is part of the show. This is intimidation. That's what it is. It's intimidation, and it's also going to set a new precedent where they're going to sue people like you and me. Now, they're not going to get me, because at the end of the day, they've already gotten me by eliminating me. And when the digital ID is in place, that's what this is for. Because, and I'll cover this in a separate video about what's going on in Australia, you'll be able to post anything on the internet without it coming back to you. So there'll be no trolling. You know, you can troll, but you'll be held accountable for your trolling. That's what this is headed towards. You're going to have sock accounts or any of that stuff, so you can't dodge any of this anymore. That's what they want in place. So when the digital ID is in place and you put content out like my content, then you will be taken to court. Then you will be put in jail. That's what they're getting at with the digital ID and what you can and cannot say on the internet. You'll be held accountable. Now, when I'm held accountable, if I'm ever held accountable, this is what I would do in court. So if they did come after me, I'd say, prove it to me. Prove it to me. What's so and when you start talking to people and say, what's so unhealthy about thinking it's something, you know, that it's not true? And then you bring up something like OJ, right? And say, well, everyone knows he's a murderer. But then you say, well, somebody thought he wasn't and he got off on it, right? You go, oh, that's true, right? Because that's what people are allowed to have a difference of opinion, right? Right. But say, you know, it's almost like, what, you're not allowed to question what happened there and there wasn't even a trial? You have to take it verbatim, right? Because why? The government told us? Oh, because parents were crying, but they couldn't hire actors. They couldn't have had a pop-up town show up. I mean, they couldn't have had such a low budget on the event that they had a father play a role of an FBI agent and the role of a father, and then even show up in the courtroom where Alex Jones could have said on the stand, tell me about the... Big pictures of the IMDb page. Pictures from that. Of course he didn't do it. Of course he didn't do it. He just laid down because that's what they told him to do. Go there, lay down, don't question. question it, act like a jerk, say that you're mean, so society, garners more hate towards you. And then we can set a precedent for anyone else out there who talks about conspiracies, and this is what will happen to you if you question the news. Point blank, period. That's the end of the story. You haven't heard Jones since then ever bring it up, right? All he does is just play the victim. I owe all this money. I did this. Nobody out there goes, hey, why didn't you actually call it out for what it was? Why didn't you make them prove to you that it occurred? You were on national TV. You had a chance to bring up these points that we've all brought up and show it to the world. And people out there don't never have found channels like mine. They suddenly would probably go, wait, that is weird. That is the same guy playing two roles. No matter what their take is, they wouldn't be able to deny it. And he didn't do that. Why didn't he do it? He wasn't allowed to do it because it was a show. It was theater, political theater. In this case, theater to set up new laws and precedents for people like me and you. So Jones is not selling off InfoWars. They could put a different name on who owns InfoWars. This is the beginning of what it's going to look like. But Jones is still going to play. The pivotal role in the future, because they're going to bait people into going into conservative states with people like Jones. Oh, I can speak freely here. Oh, I have my freedoms back. Oh, I can own my gun. That's what these people are going to serve in the future. It's going to be two separate states, two separate laws, okay? And people like us are going to get forced into going into these red states and be sitting ducks unless we can infiltrate the blue states. But that's another topic that I go into in other videos. And it's way down the line, but not that far. Watch what happens when we get through these fake elections in 2024. You'll start seeing very quickly that that is where we're headed, because the outcome of that election, which is predetermined, is all, everything that's going to come out of that, all the false flags are all setting up for the separation of states. And that's what these trials right now, these faux trials with Trump and with Biden, are for. Oh, Trump might go to jail. Biden's got all this evidence against him. He's going to be let off. And I'll cover that when it happens. All it is psychological. And they're using these people to psychologically manipulate you into doing the things they want you to do. Don't fall for it. I thank you all for being here. Probably going to get a strike of the video. But be sure you subscribe to Hurting Humanity if you haven't yet. If you're still listening at this point, I doubt anyone is. But thanks again, everybody. God bless all of you, as always, and your families.